हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आईके सर केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। हेयर वी आर इन लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑन आईआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी अप्लाइड टू इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। दिस वीडियो इज इन अकॉर्डेंस विथ द सिलेबस ऑफ एमएससी फाइनल ईयर इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री स्टूडेंट्स। दिस विल बी आल्सो हाईली useful and beneficial to NET GRF and GATE aspirants. In this video, we will discuss application of IR spectroscopy in the determination of symmetry of metal carbonyls. It is often possible to predict the symmetry of arrangement of the carbonyl groups around the metal atom in a metal carbonyl from the number of carbonyl stretching bands in the IR spectrum. With the help of IR spectrum of a metal carbonyl, it is generally possible to predict the symmetry of arrangement of carbonyl groups around the metal atom. However, this task requires the adequate amount of judgment and proper experience in order to avoid the errors. This procedure consists of following steps. First of all, several possible structures of the metal carbonyl under consideration are drawn. For the given metal carbonyl, various possible structures are drawn. The number of carbonyl stretching bands, which are expected to appear in the IR spectrum, is calculated from the symmetry of each structure with the help of physical and mathematical requirements. It means for each of the structure drawn for the metal carbonyl, the number of expected absorption peaks in the IR spectrum is calculated from the symmetry and mathematical and physical requirements of the given structure. The experimental observations are then compared with the above predictions. Then IR spectrum scanned experimentally is compared with the above predictions. The structures which disagree with the experimental observations are discarded. In favorable circumstances, there will be only one structure remaining, and that is the predicted structure of that metal carbonyl. The reliability of this procedure can be enhanced appreciably if the approximate force constants of the bonds and relative intensities of the bands are also taken into account. The reliability of this procedure can be increased with the help of two additional studies, the approximate force constants of the bonds and the relative intensities of the bands are also taken in account. Let us illustrate the above procedure taking example of cis and trans isomers of metal carbonyls of the type Ml2CO4. Let us explain the above procedure taking example of cis and trans isomers of the metal carbonyls of this type Ml2CO4. two possible structures for such metal carbonyls are given here. Cis isomer in which two ligands L are present adjacent to each other, and the other possible structure is trans isomer in which two ligands L are opposite to each other. There are two possible structures of ML2CO4, and for each of these structure we have to calculate number of expected absorption peaks in the IR spectrum. The approximate forms of carbonyl stretching vibrations and their IR activity for the cis and trans isomers of ML2CO4, considering only symmetry of MCO whole group portion, are given in the following figure. The approximate forms of carbonyl stretching vibrations and their IR activity for the cis and trans isomers of ML2CO4, considering the symmetry of only this moiety, are given in the following figure. This is for cis isomer. Two L groups are adjacent to each other. This bond is stretched. This carbonyl group is also stretched. First mode of vibration. And it should be IR active because it leads to change in the dipole moment of the molecule. In the other mode of vibration, for the cis isomer, one bond is stretched here opposite to L, and this carbonyl bond is also stretched, and it is also IR active. Other two vibrations for cis isomer are given here. These two L groups are adjacent to each other. This carbonyl group is compressed while this carbonyl group is stretched. Similarly, in this mode of vibration, this CO bond is compressed while this CO bond is stretched. And thus we see that four possible modes of vibration for the cis isomer of ML2CO4 are possible, and all these modes of vibration are IR active. It is obvious that for the cis isomer, all the four forms of CO stretching vibrations are distinct and can absorb IR radiations, producing four absorption bands in the IR spectrum. Now let us see for the trans isomer. Two L groups are opposite to each other. In all the four modes of vibration, two L groups are opposite to each other. And these are trans isomers. These are four different modes of vibration for the trans isomer. In first mode of vibration, this CO bond is stretched, this CO bond is also stretched, this CO bond is stretched and it is again stretched. Similarly, in this mode of vibration, this CO bond is stretched, this is stretched, but these two bonds are compressed, and both of these modes of vibration should be IR inactive because these modes of vibration don't lead to change in the dipole moment of the metal carbonyl. In third one, this CO bond is stretched while the opposite CO bond is compressed, Similarly, in the fourth one, this CO bond is compressed while this one is stretched. And these two modes of vibration leads to change in dipole moment of the molecule, because here a stretching is executed while here compression is executed, and this would lead to change in dipole moment of the system. Hence, these two modes of vibration are IR active, while these two modes of vibrations are IR inactive. For the trans isomer, two modes of vibration are IR inactive, first two modes of vibration given above, because they don't lead to change in the dipole moment of the molecule. The other two modes of vibrations are IR active. Both the IR active modes of vibration are equivalent, and hence they have the same vibrational frequency. Two active modes of vibration of the trans isomer are equivalent and they have the same vibrational frequency. As a result, these IR active modes of vibration absorb the same frequency of IR radiation, giving rise to a single absorption band. For MO triethyl phosphine whole 2 CO whole 4, two isomeric compounds have been isolated. For this metal carbonyl, two isomeric compounds have been isolated, and these are cis form and trans form. One of these isomers has four absorption bands at 2016, 1915, 1900, and 1890 centimeter inverse in the IR spectrum, and thus it is certainly the cis isomer. The cis isomer of this type of metal carbonyl Ml2CO whole 4 exhibits four absorption bands in the IR spectrum. This is the cis isomer in which two triethyl phosphine ligands are adjacent to each other. On the other hand, the other isomer exhibits only one strong absorption band at 1890 centimeter inverse, and thus it is certainly the trans isomer. Two triethyl phosphine ligands are opposite to each other. It is obvious that the metal carbonyls of the type Ml2CO whole 4 has two possible isomers, cis isomer and trans isomer. The cis isomer exhibits four absorption bands in the IR spectrum, while the trans isomer exhibits only one absorption peak, only one absorption band in the IR spectrum. It is obvious that cis and trans isomers of the metal carbonyls of the type Ml2CO whole 4 can be distinguished with the help of IR spectroscopy. Thank you for watching the video with concentration. Please like, share and subscribe it. Thank you again.